Hi everyone, welcome to the data structure video lecture series. So in the previous videos we have learnt about stack array implementation, and in this video I will tell you one limitation of that implementation and how can you resolve that. Okay, so first of all, try to run our previous implementation. Okay, it was working fine. Okay, now just try to look here we have provided capacity is equal to 10. Okay, I will suggest you to please watch my previous video to get clear about this video. Okay, so here the capacity is 10, and if we try to push more than 10 elements, okay, we are just copying here the 6 elements and pasting it here. Okay, save this program and try to run this. Now we will get an error here. What is the error? Stack is full and exception in the thread. Okay, because we have the size of only 10 elements and we are pushing 12 elements. So how can we resolve that implementation? Okay, so instead of using array, we can use dynamic array, or you can say that resizable array. Okay, so how can you do that? Let's make a new class and I am naming it stack dynamic array implementation. Okay, and we will implement this from scratch. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so first of all, what we need an array, top element and a stack size. Okay, so just write private int and let's name this array as object. Okay, you can name anything. Okay, we name this private int top and private int stack size. Okay, and now we will make a constructor to initialize their value. Okay, so let's copy our class name, paste it here. Okay, now we will initialize it with we will say that consider we have an empty stack. Okay, so we will say our stack size is equal to 1 and this stack is empty, so top is equal to -1. And what we will need the value of object? Object is equal to new int and its size will be the same as what is the size of stack. Okay, so we are making an array whose size is equal to stack size, and we are initializing the stack size is equal to 1 and the top is equal to -1 signifies that the stack is empty. Okay, now what we will do, we will first implement the basic abstract data types. Those are whether the stack is empty, whether it is full, we will push operation and pop operation. Okay, so let's start from the is empty. Okay, so public int is empty. Okay, and now what is the condition of an stack to be empty? If its top element is equal to -1, so we will say if top is equal to -1, then we will say stack is empty. Okay, else we will return 0. Okay, now the next abstract data type we will implement is full. Okay, so to check whether the stack is full or not, is full. Okay, so what is the condition of a stack to be full is if the top element is equal to the capacity of the stack minus 1, and here the capacity of a stack is stack size. Okay, so we will say if top is equal to stack size minus 1, then we will say stack is full and we will return 0 because we are using int as return type. Okay, so the next abstract data type we will use is push operation and pop operation. Okay, so for pop operation, so let's say public int pop, and in stack the pop operation is whatever the element is on the top, we have to simply return it. Okay, so we will return, the array name is object, and whatever the element is on the top of the array, simply return that. Okay, now we will implement push operation. Okay, so for push operation we will say public int push, and here we have to pass an argument here, and the name of the argument, let's say int data or int item. Okay, anything. Okay, so here we will check a condition. Okay, in the previous array implementation we have not resized our array. Now we will say that if the top element is greater than equal to stack size minus 1, means if the stack is full, we will resize the array. Okay, so here you can see that, consider we have an array in which we are storing 5 elements. Okay, now if you are trying to insert any elements, 6 elements, then you will get an exception. Okay, so what you will do, that if the stack is full, means when the array will be full, you will resize the array. For example, let's say this, copy this and paste it, and here let's say hey this and this. Okay, now you had an array of 5 elements here. Now what you have done is that you have made another array which is twice the size of the initial array, and you will simply copy the items of the previous array into the new array. Okay, so there will be no exception. So what we will do, okay, so we will just check the condition, if top is greater than equal to stack size minus 1, okay, then we will simply resize the array, else we will push the data. So for pushing, we had simply increased the value of the top element by 1, and we will assign the value of item to it. Okay, so first assign the value of the top, and in assign its value. Okay, simply now we have to write the function for resize. Okay, so just, okay, so to resize you have to make another array, and suppose name this as temp. Okay, so, and assign its value to initial array, and the initial array name is object. Okay, now what we will do? We will multiply the stack size by 2. So stack size is equal to stack size into 2. Okay, and now the new value of the object will be object is equal to new int stack size. Now we have the initial array which is double of the size. Okay, now we will copy the elements, initial elements, into the new resized array. So we will make a for loop for int I is equal to 0, I less than equal to top, okay, I plus plus, and we will say whatever the element at temp, simply assign its value to the object array. Object I is equal to temp of I. Okay, so we have done with this. Okay, we have so finally make an object of your class. Okay, the class name is stack dynamic array implementation. Copy this and just try to name this st is equal to new dynamic array implementation, and first let's say st dot push, let's say 34, st dot push 78 78 7, you can put anything. Okay, now I'm just trying to copy these two and I will paste it like. Okay, so we are pushing 12 elements and our size is, we have not defined it. So let's suppose that what is our size is equal to 5. Okay, so we are getting some error here. Push. Okay, we have not added the return statement here. So we will change it to void. Okay, now our error has gone. Now what we will do? We will just try to pop element. Okay, so just try to st dot pop. Okay, and let's, what is the stack size? St dot stack size. Now just try to run this program. You can see this here, the top element is 34 because this is the element which is on the top element. Okay, now we have the stack size. Now stack size is here 16. So in this way you can implement your own stack implement data structure. So in the next video I will tell you about inbuilt stack implementation on Java. So thank you for watching this video. In the next video I will tell you more about stack and its applications. Till then, stay tuned. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye bye. Have a good day.